I ran into somebody who works in our office, and I'd asked her what she did the night before. Maybe it was over the weekend. She's like, yeah, well, I went to an I Do barbecue, and blah, blah, blah. This is kind of standard over there. I'm like, hang on a second. What's an I Do barbecue? You guys ever heard of that before?
No, like but I have
like an engagement party?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to vomit.
But only for people in the wedding party.
Right. Okay.
So
it's kind of where they do they ask them to be in the wedding party? Like that's part of the event.
I'm not really sure.
So I've been to like where they invite the bridal party over, and that's you're at a party, and they ask you to be in the bridal party. So
is that what that is?
You're going to a party, and you don't actually know yet until you get
to the party,
right.
And then they say, by the way, you're all going to be in.
Or they ask you. Yeah.
Okay.
So do attendees at. They don't know until some point in the evening when...
I mean, my brothers, I knew. I knew I was going to be in my brother's wedding, but right. Yes. And then they, you know, gave us a bottle of wine, and on the wine, you know, she had put in like a cute little saying asking us to be, you know, it was a custom-made wine label, and then, you know, it was a cute saying asking us to be in the wedding.
I would attend the I'd prefer not barbecue.
I actually never liked the idea of an engagement party. And so... You can put a cute little name on it, right, and make things rhyme, and I'm not going to like it or dislike it any more or any less.
Well, that's what they do, though. Yeah, that's what whoever they are.
There must be some counselor, commissioner, somebody who puts together, like... with the gender reveal stuff now, that went from 0 to 60.
Now, I'm wondering where this started, because there's an article on theknot.com, right, which is a wedding magazine and a wedding website. And so do you think that they wrote the article thinking that this might be a thing, or did they write the article because it already was a thing?
I think they can help boost it by reporting on it.
Right.
All the not readers. But I don't know. Usually something has to have a little bit of traction before you report on it, right?
So yeah, I would think so. But so you have an engagement party, okay?
Okay.
You have, I guess now, an I Do barbecue. You have to have a rehearsal dinner.
The rehearsal dinner is what, isn't that sort of, that's the wedding party gathering,
that's
right?
That's what I always thought
right?
It was.
Well, but not anymore, because now if you have out-of-town guests, if you're going by, their rules, you have to invite the out-of-town guests to the rehearsal dinner.
Right.
So, but the I Do, so, but out-of-town guests who are in the wedding party aren't expected to attend the I Do barbecue, are they?
I think the I Do barbecue is taking over the engagement party. I don't think you're having an I Do barbecue and you're having an engagement party. I think it's sort of one or the other.
Really?
Yeah.
So, but you would only invite...
Because an I Do barbecue is an engagement party.
Yeah, but you're really? Only inviting the people that would be in your wedding party.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I don't know if that's the case. I'm just saying that is also, I've been to parties where they only invite the bridal party.
Because let's say you have a big engagement party or your I Do barbecue, but you're only inviting some of the people that
just
are there.
Just invite people who can be in the direct wedding party.
But let's say you have like 50 people there, but you're only inviting like 7 of them to be in your wedding party. That's kind of insulting to the other people that show up.
This is
really
useless.
That's like saying you have to put every single friend in your bridal party. I think you know who's.
But if you're at a party and you're not part of the list there.
Yeah.
And you're just like, oh, I'll just be waiting over here.
Yeah.
No.
And enjoy your being celebrated by the bride and groom, and I'll just stand over here and have my fruit.
Yeah.
No, I don't think so.
So you have all these parties. What are the ones involved with having a baby? There's a shower,
the
right?
Barbara Briss.
The Barbara Briss.
But listen, like the I Do barbecue and the gender reveal, I think are kind of organized so that you don't have to bring a gift. You're not bringing a gift to, do you know what I'm saying?
A gender reveal?
Yeah, like it's more set up like the barbecue, like come over for a barbecue. You don't quite know what it is. But whereas an engagement party is, if you show up without a gift, for me, if I showed up without a gift, I would feel awkward.
All right, hang on. I just saw a text that came over. It said Connor Betts, he's an assistant producer here, went to an I Do barbecue. I'd like to know if he brought a gift with him to the I Do barbecue. Because, Kathy, I don't think I think you have to bring a gift to an I Do barbecue.
I don't know. Here, well, Connor's.
All right, we need an explanation,
right,
clarification, in case I, by some stretch of the imagination, get invited to an I Do barbecue. I want to know what to do.
Connor? I did not bring a gift.
Okay.
Were you aware that it was an I Do barbecue before you attended?
Yes.
Okay, so it's the premise of the I Do barbecue when it was presented to you that you were coming because you were going to be in, asked to be a part of this wedding party?
Yes, and I was not a part of the wedding party.
All right, did your girlfriend bring a gift?
No.
Okay.
So when you went,
Do you know what I'm saying? Like the gender reveal is to come. We're all finding out together what the baby is going to be. You're not going to bring a gift to that. The baby shower. Yes, that's the point of a baby shower. Huh. Your friends, your family, they're bringing gifts so that you can be prepared for when the baby comes.
Connor prefers to be called Moose.
Yeah.
What's that all about?
That's just a nickname from high school.
Oh, okay. I did not know that.
High school and to college and everybody calls.
Okay, him, gotcha. So. Well, I didn't know that. Nice to meet you, Moose.
So Moose, what was it like at the I Do Barbecue?
Well, I didn't bring a gift, one, because they are wealthy and
yes.
I am poor.
Right.
So I think my mom might have brought a gift, but I didn't.
And so who with the cluster that you attended, who was asked to be in the bridal party?
It was my friend's brother's engagement party, I guess. So then we were all friends with him, and it was a bunch of my friends, and then I was not asked.
Did they line you up?
I was backup.
Did they line you up in a row and then yes, no?
Yes. Yeah.
It's like picking for kickball.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
No. And then, Connor, you're there with the caterer standing there.
Yeah, it was me and the caterer and the dog.
Right, yeah.
On the side.
These are the ones who will not be in our wedding party. Shame them.
Sorry, Moose.
Why don't you forget the Moose for a moment?
But you didn't go to the party expecting to be asked to be in the bridal party, right?
No.
Yeah.
Not even a little bit?
No.
No.
With how good you look in a gown?
You don't have every friend you know in your bridal party.
No, but I'm saying this seems oddly. It is like being picked for teams in school.
No.
And you're left out of it.
No.
Why not break up into shirts and skins?
Well, I'd never heard the term I Do Barbecue before, but apparently that's another one to add to the list with your gender reveals,
right.
Your sprinkles, your showers, your engagement
golden
parties,
showers.
Your golden showers,
butterscotch bandits, your
and that's
Carl
overcomers.
That's, guys, you're combining things that
disgusting.
It's not.
Yeah, Overcomer was a movie.
We're here for the hot Carl party.
What were you going to say, guys?
I just don't make your wedding more special than it really is.
Yeah.
You know?
Or do it, since it's your wedding.
Yeah.
Don't make it more special than it really
because
is.
Because it might end up in a murder-suicide, you know?
Wow. Like,
you're not special.
Wow.
This day isn't special.
It might end up in a
They had an I Do Barbecue.
They had an
And now he's dead.
Yes. Congratulations. It might end up in a murder-suicide.
I'm Keith Morrison. It started with an I Do Barbecue and ended with, where'd you bury the body?
I love it.